Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. It's the greatest manifestation of his rahmah to his entire creation is the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And from the rahmah that this Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam gave us is his character, how he was, not simply the ahkam, but how he lived the ahkam. When Aisha radiallahu anhu was asked how was his character, she said, كان خلقه القرآن رضي به وأرضاه. He was the Quran in nature. His nature was the Quran. His character was the Quran. And the Quran is called in the Quran al-Azim. It's the Quran al-Azim. In huwa al-Qasr al-Azim. Ikhtabin maknoon. This is a vast oath. The oath of that Allah is swearing by the nature of the Quran. That this is a great Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the Quran great. And he made the Prophet's khuluq great. Because the khuluq is following the Quran. And the Quran is al-Azim. So anyone who yatakhalaqu bi akhlaq al-Quran, khuluquhu lama hala sayakun azima. Anyone whose khuluq is the Quran, is Quranic by nature, then he'll be azim. His khuluq will be azim. But the Prophet is the greatest embodiment of the Quranic character and nature. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in this ayah, we're being told that it's by Allah, or bi rahmatin min Allah. Because of a rahmah from Allah, that he made you that way. He made you a rahmah, and it's from his rahmah that he made you a rahmah. And if you were fav, fadada is harshness in the self. If you were fav, or ghalid al-qalb, ghild is heaviness. If your heart was heavy, if it was weighty,
someone here.
Somebody here.
Are they here already? Can you open the door?
Yeah.
Right, I'm coming. Yeah, but you can put this on your door, look.
I need a lock from on my door.
No, you don't.
He gave everyone who had a Jukam a haq.
Wait, so that this the laptop's recording.
Yeah.
Cool, huh? It looks like it's a video. Just don't move your hand, let me see.
That's amazing. Each person he gave them to make them feel he was the most important.
I thought you were just like copying it. It just looks like that.
He didn't make muhabbat. People didn't see muhabbat from the Prophet. In one narration, he had two sticks of siwak. And an Arabi was there. And one of them was broken. It had a wijaj in it. And the other one was straight. And he
but have you even used this?
One of the shuk said, if this is his ihar for a simple Bedouin who doesn't care if it's crooked or straight, what about the rest of the people? The people closest to him. So this was his nature was like this.
Yeah.
One of them, he said that the Prophet, he was in the prayer.
How come they hear so?